just want to bring a quick message here on the summary of the book of Acts. The summary of the book of Acts. And I think that this ought to be something that encouraged the church of today. Acts chapter number 1, let's look at verses 1 through 8. The Bible says, "The former treaties have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach until the day in which he was taken up. After that, he through the Holy Ghost had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which, saith he, ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? And he said unto them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. Verse number 8, I like verse number 8. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and all of Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth." Now let's look on over at verses 41 through 47. Verses 41 through 47 in chapter number 2. The Bible says, "Then they that gladly received his word were baptized, and the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls. And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, and in breaking of bread and in prayers. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles. And all that believed were together, and had all things common, and sold their possessions and goods, and parted them to all men, as every man had need. And they, continuing daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved." So four things I just want to point out here. I read these verses here because in these verses has the four things I want to point out to you on the summary of the book of Acts, and I think that this ought to be an encouragement to the church of today, to us. Number one, we see that Jesus went up. Thank God for the gospel. Amen. Thank God for it mentioned there in Acts chapter 1, his passion, the passion of Christ. What is the passion of Christ? And I'm not talking about the Mel Gibson movie, even though that was a decent portrayal of the passion of Christ. The passion is this, it's the gospel, it's the death, the burial, and the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm so glad that Jesus came down to this earth and took the form of a man and walked this earth sinless and blameless and perfect and took your sin and my sin upon him and willingly laid down his life and shed his blood for us and was buried and rose again the third day. What is the gospel? You find it in 1 Corinthians chapter number 15, verses 1 through 4. Jesus died for our sins according to the scriptures, was buried, and rose again the third day according to the scriptures. I'm so glad that Jesus came and he died for us and he was buried and he rose again and that he ascended up. We read that here in Acts chapter number 1. He ascended up into heaven. After he was raised from the dead, he walked this earth for 40 days. And then he gave some advice there at the very end, right before he ascended up to the disciples, what they were supposed to do. And then he ascends up into heaven. And that's an exciting thing because he also gave us a promise that the same way he went up, he would come back. Again, I'm glad that there's coming a day when I'm going to hear the trumpet sound and Jesus is going to step out on the clouds and I'm going to hear the trumpet sound and hear my name called out and hear, come up hither, and I'll be changed from here to there in a moment in a twinkling of eye, and I will have my glorified body and be in the presence of the Lord forever. But I'm glad he's also coming back to this earth and setting foot on this earth once again to rule and reign for 1,000 years during his millennial reign. That's an exciting thing. And so that's something that we ought to constantly think about and be thankful about, and that's what we should be preaching, the death, the burial, and the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We ought to preach the rapture, and we ought to preach his second coming, that he's coming again to establish his kingdom here on this earth. Amen. That's what we should be going and proclaiming. And so the summary of the book of Acts, number one, Jesus went up. Number two, the Holy Spirit came down. When Jesus went up, Jesus said he would not leave us comfortless, but he would send another comforter. And he was talking about the Holy Spirit, talking about the Holy Ghost of God. So Jesus went up. Number two, the Holy Spirit came down. And I love it over in Ephesians 1:13 and Ephesians 4:30, where it talks about how we are sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise, and we are sealed unto the day of redemption. When the moment that we put our faith and our trust in the gospel for salvation, the Holy Spirit of God moved on the inside of us and lives on the inside of us, and we are sealed unto the day of redemption. What does that mean? I cannot lose my salvation. That I am sealed. Well, I'm sealed. That means that I'm covered. I'm taken care of, and I cannot lose my salvation until the day of redemption. What is that? That day of the rapture when the trumpet sounds. Amen. I'm sealed unto the day of redemption. I'm glad the Holy Spirit dwells on the inside of me, because see, there was an emptiness inside of me, and there's an emptiness inside of you that only the Lord Jesus Christ can fill. And so we have a body, we have a soul, and we have a spirit, and we were born with a dead spirit because we were born in the sin. And so we're two-thirds the person we ought to be. Two-thirds in decimal form is 0.666. The devil has us right where he wants us, but the moment we put our faith and our trust in the gospel for salvation, put our faith in what Jesus Christ has done for us rather than what we can do for ourselves, then the Holy Spirit dwells on the inside of us and makes us whole, fills that void. And I thank God for that. So Jesus went up, the Holy Spirit came down. Number three, the disciples went out. We need to put the word go back in the gospel. Amen. Put the word go back in the gospel. Luke 14:23 tells us to go out to the highways and hedges and compel them to come in, that my house may be filled. What does that mean in there? We're to go where they are and share the gospel with those out in the world. If we're waiting for them to come in the church, that's not going to happen. We've got to go where they are. Go out to the lanes of the city, the streets and the lanes of the city, the highways and the hedges. That means everywhere, and share the gospel. Jesus told them to go out into Jerusalem and Judea and Samaria. That was their local area first. And then he said, go out into the uttermost parts of the world. We are to take the gospel everywhere. And the only way that we can take the gospel everywhere is go. Get up off of our blessed assurance and go. Go and share the gospel. Go and tell people that Jesus came and died and was buried and rose again. And if they put their faith and their trust in what Jesus has done, they too will be born again, and the Holy Spirit will dwell on the inside of them, and they will be sealed unto the day of redemption. We need to put the word go back in the gospel. So Jesus went up, the Holy Spirit came down, the disciples went out, and the lost came in. Now in Luke 14:23, we said that the Bible says, go out to the highways and hedges and compel them to come in that my house may be filled. Talking about my house. What is that talking about there? Yes, we on the surface, we can say that means the local church. The best way to build the church up for it to grow in numbers is to go out and encourage people to come in, invite people to come in. I still believe in door-to-door soul winning. I believe it works. I believe in the bus ministry. I think it's the greatest tool that the local church can have to reach people with the gospel and see the church grow. A lot of churches today are boasting that their church is growing and that, you know, they're growing in numbers, but really what's taking place in our culture today, in our society, in our country, and really in this world, is that the churches are not really growing, but rather just rotating members. And that's what's happening, is that people leave this church and go to that church. Then they leave this church and go to that church. And so, but real growth is when people get saved. And I believe that's what that's talking about there in Luke 14:23, when it says, go out to the highways and hedges, compel them to come in, that my house may be filled. I think that's talking about the kingdom of God, talking about people getting born again, hearing the gospel and getting saved. Now, once somebody gets saved, they get born again, I believe they should get rooted into the local church and grow spiritually. And then they too go out to the highways and hedges and compel people to come in. And this process should continue to repeat itself. And that's what was happening here in the book of Acts. The people got on fire for God. They got saved. They got on fire for God. And you see that there were thousands that got saved at one time. And then you notice there, I like Acts chapter 2, verse 47, where it says, praising God and having favor with all the people, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. We were to see the church grow daily. And the only way that's going to happen is if we go out and share the gospel. So the summary of the book of Acts applies for us today. Jesus went up, the Holy Spirit came down, the disciples went out, and the lost came in. And that is the method the church ought to be pushing today. Preaching that Jesus came, he died, he was buried, he rose again, he ascended up to heaven, and one day he's coming back. In the meantime, he has sent the Holy Ghost to come and convict us and dwell in the hearts of the believers. And that the believers should go out and share the gospel so that the lost can come in. Amen. That's our job. Let's be about our Father's business.